Welcome to Glasgow, to the Bank of Scotland Great Scottish Run 2015. 15,000 starters assembling in George Square in the heart of the city before they embark upon a half-marathon journey, 13.1 miles around the streets and parks of Glasgow. The elite fields include the women's defending champion Edna Kiplagat and the Commonwealth 10,000-metre champion in this city last year, Moses Kipsiro. There's local interest too in the form of Callum Hawkins, who makes his marathon debut at the end of the month. Well, let's meet the principals then. Gemma Steele, the first up on the right of your shot, the European cross-country champion. She's been twice second in the Great North Run, of course, is over the half-marathon distance. And in good form, we're told. Well, certainly Callum Hawkins from the Great Britain and Kelebarkan Club, sixth in this race last year. He's in good form too, looking forward to a marathon later on. More about that during the race. Well, Joe Pavey, European 10,000-metre champion, has competed, believe it or not, in four Olympic Games and wants to make it five in Rio. Well, Japhet Korir, fabulous on the country, a former world cross-country champion and Great Ireland run champion this year. So he's in good 10K form. How will he fare over the full distance of half marathon? Well, Edna Kiplagat, well, defending champion, twice world half marathon champion. She really is a talent and will take some beating today. Well, Moses Kipsiro, twice Commonwealth 10,000 metre champion. And really, 2014 was a close finish. It was, I think, 3/100ths of a second. But before in 2:10, much, much bigger margin. 15,000 on their way. Personal stopwatches, of course, as always. The half marathon distance, 13.1 miles. And much to be admired here from many club runners. You see the personal stopwatches being checked. They don't actually believe in these chips, some people. But of course, once they get to the line, the clock has already started, so they need their own personal time, and they can check it on the way round. I guess that's the reason that they have the personal watches. They've been training, they've done some runs. A lot of people will be running this for the first time. There are a lot of good club runners in this as well, of course, who've run the half marathon distance before. But a lot of money being raised for charity too. This is something which is part and parcel of the Great Run series during the whole of the British road running series. They raise so much money, millions and millions of pounds for good causes. Slide uphill on this first part of the course, which will mean that the elite, I would think, would start to move slightly away, and it will affect the time. It is actually an undulating course, this. It's pretty quick, but there are some ups and downs in every sense, particularly in the middle of the course. And this city, of course, which hosted the Commonwealth Games in 2014, much admired now throughout the Commonwealth. And look at this, the way in which the leading group is beginning to move away. This is a mixed race, of course, so the women will be a little bit further back, but the leading group, I can see the principals we've introduced, including Collis Birmingham, incidentally. Ah, and Isaiah Kowich is there as well, but we understand he's not in great form at the moment. Johnny Meller on the tail end of that group as well, but look how they spread out. And I'm not surprised, because they're running miles in around about 4:42, or they will be during the course of this half marathon. Well, let's catch up with the course itself now over the 13.1 miles. It's a good course too. It starts in George Square with an awful lot of spectators in that square. There are the undulations that I talked about, the midpoint of the race uphill, past the Hydro, incidentally, and over Kingston Bridge, and then back down towards Pollock Park. And Pollock Park represents, or that's coming out of Pollock Park, will represent the halfway mark, and then beyond and heading towards the Bella Houston Park. Here we go north again towards Bella Houston Park, towards the left. And then they'll turn back in the direction of the finish and past Ibrox there and past the Pacific Quay, across the Squinty Bridge, and to finish in, there's the Squinty Bridge, and heading towards Glasgow Green and the finish. It's a good course, but look at that. It is up and down, as I said, and that'll test a few people. Well, Josephette Korir takes on the leading role. Also in there is Segei Twelde of Eritrea. He stayed in Scotland after the 2008 World Cross Country Championships. He's there, Kipsiro on the left. And Callum Hawkins, too, is looking forward to a marathon in Frankfurt in the near future. There's Johnny Miller behind him. Just off the back of this leading group, if he's going to compete here, he needs to get closer order than that. And Isaiah Coetzee, of course, has a great track form over the years. Not quite in that sort of form, you understand, at the moment. But Correa, very happy to take this on. Not greatly experienced at the half marathon. And the women, well, I can see Edna Kiplagat in the leading group. There's, well, everyone's there. Joe Pavey, Gemma Steele, Sarah Moreira of Portugal, who's going for a marathon shortly on November the 1st. So there'll be a lot of miles in her legs. Don't expect her to push this too hard. But it's a part of the preparation for the marathon, of course. It's useful for the women to be able to latch on to some of the men running at the sort of pace that they want to run at. And Changewo is there on the left in that purpley vest. And Moreira in the blue top in the midst of that field. The leading group, as one expected, all together. Joe Pavey there as well. An early pace looks good, actually. There's the Kingston Bridge, and it's a bit lonely out there, I have to say, and it's not the sort of place you'd find the crowd, but the men pushing on. Kipsira looks so comfortable, doesn't he? I mean, to be a double Commonwealth champion, as he was in 2010, over 5 and 10, he didn't do that last year. He only just won the 10,000. He was well down the field in the 5,000. Kipsiro then looks very, very comfortable indeed. Just looking at him, he's, as I said, twice Commonwealth champion, but that 53-second lap and the last lap of that 10,000 metres in 2010 was very, very impressive. It really was. He withdrew from the World Cross Country Championships in a dispute with his federation, actually, this year. It was strange, but he missed that and... But nevertheless, oh, look at Collis Birmingham. Collis Birmingham, eighth in the World Cross Country Championships some time ago. I mean, Collis, the tall figure in the back there, the Australian. And alongside him, just to give him a Menigsteb of Eritrea, is another one that stayed in Scotland after the World Cross Country Championships in Edinburgh in 2008. And Shettleston Harriers, of course, both of them. And that club has benefited greatly from their staying over. And of course, Twelde. He's got a British passport, actually, got that in December last year, but not yet cleared by the IAAF to compete for Great Britain. Well, Callum Hawkins looks good, six down now in the leading pack, and it is a pack and they'll be helping each other. I just wonder how long they'll stay together because they're running around about 63-minute pace at the moment. And, of course, when you look at Kipsiro's best time, that is 63.15 in last year. But, quite frankly, he's not run too many of these. Edna Kiplagat out there, along with Changewo. Now, Changewo, Commonwealth Games silver medal at 10,000 metres in 2010, has featured in the top four in the World Cross Country Championships. That was back in 2008. This year's on the left of his shot. And looked very good. And Joe Pavey, of course, looking for... another Olympic berth than in 2016. I mean, she is really quite something to win. She's looking actually for a British record for over 40s on this day. And I just wonder whether that might well be a possibility because to run close to 70 minutes would be quite something because that the British best is held by Lily Partridge, actually, at 70 minutes and 32, and they're round about that sort of pace at the moment, probably a little bit quicker, actually. And the world best, actually, is 69.37, Dina Caster last year. So there's a couple of reasonable targets, but the men, well, no one prepared to sort of really push it on, and I'm not surprised. 4 miles gone past for the men now. And I reckon they're running around about 63, probably a slightly quicker, although it's early. Remember, 13.1 miles, just to remind you. And mile three was 4 minutes and 45, incidentally. And mile four, 4:52. So that three to four was 4:45, just clearing that up. But look at the way... Oh, look at this. Kiplagat's put the pedal down. Well, that is an astonishing. She is so confident, Edna Kiplagat. I mean, she's got the talent, hasn't she? She's the defending great Scottish run champion. Twice world champion, and also London Marathon winner last year, so she knows the roads well. A great, great talent. A best of 67.41, 67 minutes, just coming through 4 miles, and at 21.60. Now that is 69 and a half pace. 69 minutes, so she is running sub 70, and I would assume also that Chengwewo is as well. Chengwewo is a good athlete, 68.49 her best, but that was back in 2011. And Gemma Steele is now back about 20 or so metres. And if Gemma's going to feature here, she really does have to get back into contact. But remember, Gemma has a best of 68.13 set last year. So this is within her compass. But certainly, after only the first 4 miles, Edna Kiplagat really has posed her intent. Into Pollock Park, and remember, when they come out of Pollock Park, towards the exit of Pollock Park, then they're about halfway in this half marathon. And Callum Hawkins looks good. Now then, what's he got to do? He's got a best of 63.06. Now, I reckon that they're round about that sort of pace, so probably a little bit quicker. So I'm not surprised that he's there, but he's putting real pressure on here, isn't he? Absolutely superb. And the Collis Birmingham looks as though he's dropping right off the back. I think that's Collis. But he's going off the back of that group now. Yes, it is Collis Birmingham. So we've still got Mengisteb there, the Eritrean, in the red shorts and the blue top towards the back. But certainly Moses Kipsira, just a word about him, made his first senior international appearance in the World Championships in 2005, a decade ago, and that was in the heats of the 5,000 metres. He also competed in the Commonwealth Games in 2006 in Melbourne. He was seventh in the 5,000. And, of course, we all know what happened in 2010. I've already mentioned the double there for the 5 and 10,000 gold medals. But really, he is an absolutely superb athlete and looks so very, very comfortable indeed. Birmingham's dropped off the back. And Mengisteb as well. Well, Edna Kiplagat in the background there leading the women away there. And Joe Pavey looked right on her shoulder. And it looks as though Gemma Steele in that reddish top has caught up a little bit here. And that gives her a real chance of competing against this absolutely superb Kenyan athlete, the defending champion. I mention it again because she's done so much. Changi Weo also doing very nicely. But look at this. There's a break in the men's race, and it's a good break as well. Now then, who's taking it on? Is it Kipsiro? Is it Jusfat Korea? Which of the two? But this is superb. Bella Houston Park. And let me tell you, the last few miles, the third mile I mentioned at 4:45, the fourth mile 4:52, the fifth mile 4:50, the sixth mile at 4:50. Well, Edna Kiplagat, look at the margin she's opened out in such a short space of time. She's absolutely destroyed this field already. Absolutely unbelievable. And that, 6 miles, sub 69. She is definitely running sub 69. Now, how fast the rest will go, who will know? So Mike Deason of the Shettleston Club again was, second in the Scottish 3000 steeplechaser. He's a steeplechaser, works at Glasgow University, a young man who's come under great pressure as they go through 8 miles. It really is quite something. He's a 2:34 marathon man, so he's got a lot of opposition in the form of Edna Kiplagat here. But nevertheless, this young woman deep in concentration. And look at this, Callum Hawkins going well, Kipsiro going well, and also Jadafet Korea also going well. They're the three, and they're away from the rest through 9 miles now, this group. And that's Tweldy off the back. 9 miles, 43.12, fractionally inside 69 minutes, so that's what I make it. The masses in Pollock Park, of course, approaching the halfway. Once they come out of the park, as I said earlier, they'll be halfway. And still some of these runners going at a good pace. This is good running. A lot of club athletes, you can see, as you go through. There'll be a lot of people who are doing this for the first time. They'll have had advice, they'll be running, and this will be a new experience for them. But this, look at this. A career now has absolutely taken off. Fantastic running by him. Unbelievable stuff. And his 10th at 15K, 44.48, well, that around about 63 minutes, probably a little bit inside, and I wouldn't be a bit surprised if he doesn't push it along a little bit. Ibrox Stadium there, just going past as they head towards the latter part of this half marathon run. But Kipsiro looks so very, very comfortable, doesn't he? Absolutely floating along. But you have to say that the young man from Scotland, Callum Hawkins, from the Kilbarkin Club, is going very nicely indeed. And remember, he's got that race in Frankfurt in October. It's actually October the 25th this month. So, well, he's in good form, very good form. And so is Edna Kiplagat. Looks so comfortable, doesn't she? Absolutely superb in her running. Totally in tune with the environment. Absolutely streets ahead in every way from the best of the rest. And when you looked at the lineup at the start, you had to say, well, Edna Kiplagat has come here to defend her time. Remember, she holds the course record, which is set last year, 67.41. I think it's actually a little bit slower than 40, but 67.15, actually. And the men approaching the Squinty Bridge now. And a lonely encounter, but look at this. Callum Hawkins in the background has really gone ahead of Correa. And remember, Correa is a former World Cross Country champion. So this is really a good sign as Hawkins heads towards that first marathon. The Squinty Bridge, one of the features here in Glasgow. And they'll now start to head down towards the finish. And look at the distance there. Ah, now Gemma Steele. Now, this is interesting. Gemma Steele and Changewo battling for second and third. And Joe Pavey's just behind. Now, remember, Joe Pavey's looking for that record performance, which is Lily Partridge at 70 minutes and 32. That's the best over 40. But I tell you what, if they're getting under 70 minutes or thereabouts, which they are, because Kiplagat has now moved well down under towards sub-69, then there could be one or two of these athletes who are close to personal bests. Towards the end of this endeavour now for Moses Kipsira of Uganda, a man who really has had real problems in the past. Remember his 2011 season, he had malaria, he had typhoid, and he came out in the 5,000 metres in the 2012 London Olympics and featured, not unsurprisingly, in 15th place. But he's come good again. He's recovered from all of that and heading now towards the finish to become the McLaren Arch there as he goes through to the finish. And that is not going to be a course record, which is 61.09. He's outside of that. That was Haile Gebrselassie, incidentally, in 2013. That's the course record. He's going to be outside the course record. But nevertheless, he's going to be, by the look of it, inside 62, or just about. Could be just outside 62, actually, as the clock counts down. Yes, he is going to be just outside. But nevertheless, this big crowd in the final stage in Glasgow Green, celebrating a very, very fine run by Moses Kipsira of Uganda. Here he comes, the great Scottish run champion for 2015, Moses Kipsira, but the crowd supporting a Scot behind him, and Callum Hawkins has had a terrific run. And on the basis of this, it will give him great confidence. A personal best for him, 63.06 coming in here, and I reckon that is under 63, according to that, unofficially under 63 minutes, so it's a personal best going in towards the end of October, his first marathon run. And that's terrific stuff from him, and that should mean a useful A very useful marathon debut for him. This is Jazafet Korea coming through, the former world champion at cross country. Over 10K, he's a pretty useful athlete world class. Edna Kiplagat, remember, Beijing recently, fifth in that World Championship marathon. And, of course, the Kenyan women did far better than the men. As far as Robert Gilroy is concerned, he's got a very, very talented running partner in the form of Edna Kiplagat. Heading towards the finish now, remember, 65 minutes gone, Chengewo. Oh, look at this, and Gemma Steele now. Can Gemma Steele come back to Chengewo? Chengewo is very, very good over 10,000 and on the track. And she was sixth in the Lisbon Half Marathon this year, fifth in the Cape Town 12K. And Joe Pavey also closing in at the final stages. Now, the race, though, has been won in dominant form by a young woman who really in the Olympic Games was fifth, but the Kenyans did better than the men, and that's something to say. But this young woman with 200 meters to go is back in real form on the roads. Remember, twice World Half Marathon champion, the London Marathon champion last year, the defending great Scottish run champion, has come here to defend the title, and she's defended it very, very successfully. Terrific stuff in the final stage. Look at the support that she's getting as she approaches. Look, just approaching 68 minutes. That pace was at 70, 71, 72. It speeded up through the whole race, and once Edna Kiplagat got underway, then she was the one that pushed it under 69 minutes. You can see the clock just over 68 as she approaches the finish, and Edna Kiplagat of Kenya becomes the great Scottish run champion for 2015. And the time just inside 68 and a half. In fact, 68.23 was the unofficial time there. We'll get the official time, I'm sure. But that's a very, very fine performance. Now the battle for second place will be quite some battle, I would think. Chengewo looks as though she's won that, and Gemma Steele coming into third place. And that, I think that margin's a bit big, but there's Joe Pavey. And they're heading, well, look at this clock as they come down this straight. It could be all four of them under 70 minutes, which would be terrific. Absolutely sensational, and it would mean that Joe Pavey would take the British record for us an over 40, which stands at 70.32. A little luck at the watch there, she's certainly going to do that. No question at all. So Joe Pavey following Gemma Steele in, following Doris Chengewo of Kenya. And what a finish between that three. Chengewo then coming into second place. And it's a fine run, 69.50. That's her best run since her best performance was set, in 2011, if I remember correctly. Yes, at 68.49. Joe Pavey, sub-70. What a performance. And she's taken the British best for an over 40. And that is quite something. It really is. She says she wants to go for the Rio Olympics, her fifth Olympic Games. Gemma Steele. Well, Gemma has been under 69 before, but that time, she's just under 70 minutes. Well, there's confirmation of the men's result. Kipsiro, 62.18. Callum Hawkins, 62.42. And Jazafet Korea, just outside 63 minutes. And Kiplagat, well, a dominant force, wasn't she? 68.21, ahead of Chengewo, ahead of Gemma Steele. But Joe Pavey takes another record.
It's another good day for me after I successfully defended my title here in Great Scots Run. I'm happy. I feel great to defend my title once again. I love running here because of people here in Scotland are great and they are friendly. They supported me very well last year, and this year I had a good welcome too, so I'm happy about the people here in Great Scots Run.
I'm so delighted to be back here in Glasgow. Yeah, it has been a great to me. Yeah, and I take Glasgow to be like it gives me success, because you know last year it gives me the memories of Commonwealth Games, and really today I'm grateful and I'm so thankful to the people of Glasgow, because they are so cheerful, supportive. You know, all the way I was running, they were cheering me up, so I'm very grateful.
It was another successful event then for the Commonwealth Games host city and a double success for African distance running. But next up for us, the great Birmingham run, also over the half marathon distance, followed hot on the heels by the great South run over 10 miles. But don't forget, keep up to date on our website, greatrun.org. From Glasgow, goodbye.